Hi, I'm Craig Phillips. In this video, I'm going to show you how I covered this entire wall and the door using Trepanel acoustic boards. Now, this is the acoustic panel I'm going to be using. The sizes of them are 2.4 meters high, which is about 8 foot, and 600 millimeters wide, which is about 2 foot. They're interlocking, but I'll show you how they interlock in a moment when we get the first panel up. Now, what you've got to decide on is which part of the area you want to start on. There's no set rules. We predominantly want to cover up a door. But what is important about it is wherever we have our panels coming across, when they bridge over the top of the door, where those lines come down, they must continue in a straight line there, and we don't want them offset. So the one option will be you start and you cut your panel that would fit on your door. Your off-cut piece then would go above your frame and you'll continue those lines in situ and work your way from the left to the right. The second option, which is what I'm probably going to start with, is placing it up against one side, checking that it's level, and then if it is, continue, work my way across. My second panel then will bridge across the corner of the door frame and of course will be cut, but that'll set my precedent where the lines need to come down and continue through the doorway. Now you've decided where your first panel is going to be installed. It's worth marking out along the wall to see where the rest of them are going to be installed, because what you don't want to do is end up with little small cuts in important areas around the door frame. So my first one is going to start here at 600, push that up against there. We've already established that I've got a good sized piece here and my cut will continue to about this point. 600, which will be there, that's on average, and the next one beyond that then we'll go from there and we'll finish around here, which is great. So then when the full piece goes on there, I'll be cutting a little small slither off where it steps over the top of the frame here, and it won't happen to be putting a little small slither in there, which wouldn't look that good. That'll bring me another full one from about there to there, leaving me with, again, a good healthy cut there, which is about just under 500 millimeters. So it'll be a small amount cut off, and that'll give me our four full boards across the wall. Now you're ready to install your first board. Now there's a number of different ways you can fix them to the surfaces. One is you can apply a glue on the back of it, place it into position, and that'll hold nice and tight once it's dry. However, I prefer to put a screw in the top and bottom of it just to hold them into position until the glue is dry while you continue with the other boards. Alternatively, if you're going into a solid wall, which holes would have to be drilled in using a masonry drill bit, then a plastic plug would be applied, then the boards could be screwed and fixed to the wall without the use of glue. For this demonstration, I'm going to be gluing the boards to the wall. So I'm using a multi-use glue, and I'm applying it on across a line at the top, and then I'm zigzagging across the board about every 300-400 millimeters apart. I'll continue this from top all the way down to the bottom, and then I'll strike one straight line all the way up the left and right hand side. Now you've applied the glue on the back of the board, spin it over, offer it up into position, press it firmly against the plasterboard, check with a spirit level to see it's level, and then you can drive a couple of screws in top and bottom just to hold it into position. I'm using a black drywall screw, so if you leave it in place, you won't see it. Now, I mentioned earlier about both sides being interlocking. This is an offcut off a previous job we did. The shade is a different colour, but if we look along one end here, we can see that this is standing proud, where on this side, it's actually sunken in. So that will interlock. And like that, it'll hold it into position, stop it pulling out, and then it'll give you a similar gap to what you've got along here. Now, depending on what type of door frames and architrave you have at home, you have got a couple of options of how you get around it. One option is you can interlock your board in, bring it up to here and cut it flush with there and go around the top of the frame. Well, the other option is, if you feel comfortable to, you can remove the architrave off here to expose the edge of the frame, and then you tuck your board in and bring it all the way to the inner edge of your frame. I'm using a sharp trimming knife just to cut the paintwork between the architrave and the frame. Once you've done that on the three inside edges of the frame, then you can take a chisel and a mallet and start to gently chip away
until you can lever the architrave away from the frame. It can sometimes be a bit tricky to start with, but once you get behind it, it should come off quite easy.
So I'm going to place my second board now back up into position, interlock the foam behind it so it anchors it into place. And when I pull this along here, I can now see the back of my frame up there. So I'm going to take a marker pen and mark it from the inside, just along the edge of the inside of the frame. Press it against it. And mark it all the way down. Now you may not be able to see the black marker line that I've put all the way down the back of here, because these boards of course are black. You could always use a white piece of chalk, which would work well. But where my mark comes all the way up here and then comes down there, which is at the top of the door, I'm going to use a bit of masking tape just to highlight it for me exactly where it is, because although I've marked it there, I'm not actually cutting it there. And the reason being is our board's going to come all the way to the end of here, as we've explained. And if you do choose to clad around the inside of your frame, they'll be coming down and that'll be fine. That'll meet the corner of there. However, your top one above the door, when that comes down, we've got it marked to be flush there. And if I cut these down and have them underneath like this, what I don't want to do is see that cut edge. That cut edge coming under the bottom of the door. What I want is the panels above it to actually cover it that way. So what I need to do next is transfer the thickness of this, because of course that will be coming down below my mark. So if I place that off cut of the board flush with here, and then have another mark here, which I can just about see, and I don't have any chalk with me, so I'm going to put some more light masking tape on there, and that is where my cut is going to be. So this top bit there is going to be longer and it will come down and cover the edge of these cut pieces here. So I can remove that one now. I know that's the cut I'm going to commit to. So I'm going to cut the foam from this side just by placing a set square on here. And then I'm going to turn that over, transfer that same line on the face of the slats and cut them with a handsaw. Okay, so now that is cut, I've cut through the first three sections there. My mark is on the other side, so I'm just going to double check that, and I think I'm going to be cutting directly along the line of the slat here. So I won't cut it from behind, I'll simply use my trimming knife and use that as a straight edge to cut along the slat. So that's almost cut all the way through. Perfect. Now I've hoovered the dust up from the cut. If you look closely to it, you can see it's a lovely smooth cut, no splintered edges. It's like a manufactured result. And that's what you get when you put your masking tape over the top and then just splice it down using your trimming knife and then cut it with your handsaw. So now I can lift this cut up and offer it into position. Again, sliding the one end of the foam behind the other one, so it holds it in place. As we can see, that now is a perfect flush cut with the inside edge of the frame there. And we've got our overhang here coming down. I'm going to guess about 20, 30 millimetres down, and that'll allow for, if we do clad the inside of this, it can butt up to there and we won't see the cut edge facing out forward. And then I've got another little trick, what I'm going to show you later, what we do with these cut edges on the underside. But that's when it's fitted into position. First of all, you're going to have to apply your glue on the back of the board, just the same as you did with your first panel.
zigzagging the board about every 300 millimeters apart. The glue I'm using is a fast drying multi-use grab adhesive. Then you can spin your panel around, again place it up into position, make sure you hook and interlock that foam into your first panel. Gently tap it all over, then drive another couple of screws, both in the top and the bottom of the board.
Now for the third panel, which is going to bridge across the top of the door frame. I'll take a measurement right up to the ceiling. Mine's coming down 380 millimeters. So I will transfer that mark on both sides of this panel at the top. 380 there and 380 there. I'm going to place my masking tape right over the top of that line. Just remark that.
By scoring the top surface of the panels with a trimmer knife allows me to get a smoother cut when using a handsaw.
So I'll take my cut, offer it up into position before any glue is put on the back of it, double check it fits, it slots behind there, and of course it'll come to this end. The off cut, which is the bigger piece in this occasion, will be the piece that goes on the door and come all the way down there, but we'll line that up later. We'll bridge this all the way around first. But one thing now, I've just realized, we come to here, I put a little pencil mark just there. That's where this one's going to finish, of course. The problem I have then is my next piece that comes along, which will be here, it'll slot in and touch that bit at the back. It starts there. When that piece is in position and this whole piece is along here, that's where it fits here. Now, there's two ways we can get around this. We could continue with it like this, and then we could take an additional slat and bridge that over the top of it there. Glue and fix that on into position and then address the sides there and make a nice corner out of that. However, I'm not keen on gluing one small piece on the end there for that. So what I am going to do is go back up to my centerpiece here. I'm going to take this piece off, trim down the felt, which then will take this across to here, about there, which will now finish me on this side around about here. So this piece that comes in then will straddle over that, and that will be connected to that back foam board on there, and we'll hold it in stronger and we can trim this off and work our sides around it. So now I've got to remove this slat here, and on the opposite side of it they are stapled in about every 180 millimeters apart to make them nice and strong. So I'm going to remove them staples just with a pair of pliers. So now that's removed, the next stage is cutting down some of the black foam here. And we've just got to get a position where that is going to be, because our next board then will come along and interlock into it here. And at the same time, we want to try to keep the same gap to marry in with all of these. And place this little slat in position and use that as a straight edge to cut the foam. That's trimmed down. That can slide into here, giving me the same size gap as all the rest, so it looks seamless. And then my next one can fix into there.
With this section of panel being a small square, I'll apply a line of the adhesive around 50 millimeters from the edge around all four sides, and then one line through the center.
Right up to the ceiling, keeping it nice and flush along here, checking that we've got enough space below to get our slats in there too. Now for my fourth panel, which should go from floor to ceiling hook in behind this one that's bridging the door frame, and that shouldn't require any cutting off. It's overhanging on this at the moment, but when I do my retains on the frame here, when that's mounted on and that's mounted on, might just have to trim down that phone, or I might even adapt it where this panel comes and sits on the face of it like this for the corner, and then continues back that way. But I'll deal with these edges later. I just want to get this one glued and fixed into position now.
Just like the other panels, interlock the foam into the previous board that's already fixed in place. Once you've leveled it up, press it down with your hands and drive a couple of screws in the top and bottom.
Now for my fifth and final board for the wall, is going to be fitted on the end here. So I'll just take a couple of measurements of this, 535, same again at the bottom, 535, and then I'll need to measure from there, allowing for my 5mm where it tucks behind, 535, which is taking me right up to this second slat here, flush along there. So again, I'll use that as my straight edge to cut down. And it is wise at this point as well to just double check that your corners, to see if they are level and you don't need to take off a couple of slats and then adjust or cut the foam on an angle to marry into the wall if it's just fallen out of fraction. There we go. This piece I'll be using on the insides of them, so we won't be wasting them.
Now it's cut, check that it fits into position before you apply your glue.
And that fits perfect, so I'll do the same, remove it, apply some glue on the back, fix it into position. So that's my wall completed. The next stage is to do the center of the door, the main part of the door, and that of course is keeping the lines in line coming all the way down, and then I can turn my attention to these side bits here. Now, I will have a couple of options. I think I'm going to remove this draft excluder from around there. And one option would be to fit the strips down with the foam on the back of it and create this for a corner, or even stepping it out. However, for me, this looks a little bit wider than what we've got here. So I'm actually going to take the back, the foam off the back, just get a couple of these, paint this black, and then fix them on, either flush or step them out a little bit so it marries in with what we've got there, and it looks like it'll just flow around the actual frame. But first of all, it's getting this trim off, painting that black, and then I'll focus on getting this door, keeping them in line, and they will be the last pieces to go on. I've removed the draft excluders from around that inner edge, and I've also painted the inside edge of the actual frame black. I'm just going to trim off this little overhang of felt here. This was the full piece where we started in there. So I'm going to trim this back and remove it. This foam is about 10mm thick, and it cuts after a couple of strikes with a sharp trimming knife. There we go. Okay, so that's off. Now that's taken me almost flush to there, but we're standing, well, we're not actually, we're standing about 10mm wide. So I get myself a little bit of foam, pop it on there. That now is bringing it flush to that. So I think I can retain my corners quite well there. Now on this side where we mentioned that isn't, that's stepping back a little bit. So I'm going to take the slats off and stick them on without any foam on, just to balance it out and make up that 10 or 15 millimeters. But I'm going to cut this large piece now. This is the off cut from here that I've still got on my workbench. I'm going to cut off a small bit from the top, which is just 65 millimeters wide off this piece. And then we should have enough for in there, and then that should then fit the door, and it'll continue all the way down just the way we want it. So from this, it's 65 there. And 65 this end.
I'm marking the line with my pencil, then placing the tape over before I start to score it with the trimmer knife. This will give me a smoother edge once cut.
Now that this section is cut down to size, I'll turn it over, put some glue on the back of it, place it into position, and as you'll see, it's a little bit short of the width of the door. These are only 600 millimeters wide and the door is about 700. So I've cut an off-cut down to size and I'll glue that into position. For this panel, I'm going to apply the adhesive directly to the door, covering all the flat areas and not the concave recess areas. Therefore, you're going to get a better bond between the door and the panel. You may need to pack it below and then screw it down. Again, two screws in the top and two screws in the bottom. I've cut another off-cut to complete the door. Again, just apply your glue on the back of this, place it into position and screw it top and bottom. Now I'm ready to tattle the inside edges of my door frame on both sides. I've got a strip cut down to length and I've took off the acoustic board off the back of it and pulled the pins out. Now, initially I was thinking I could put two strips in each side. The first one was going to come flush with this, giving me a nice space in there. And then I thought I'd put a second one in here. However, it's a little bit tight for me and we're not going to have a gap between there and there. So this door frame size isn't quite wide enough for me putting two on. It might be for you at home. All casings are different, so just double check what you can get away with. So I'm not going to put the two in there. I'm going to put the one. And this one is going to be set back a fraction, so it's not quite flush to the front there, but I have still got the same size gap here for my foam, what we can see, and I've got a little bit of a larger gap just in between there, which I don't mind that, because that distinguishes where the wall is, where the frame is, and where the door is. It's not an invisible door, so people are going to be able to see where it is when they want to enter in and out. So I'm just going to fit the one slat on both sides of my frame. That's my two side edges now stuck down to the inside edge of the door frame. So all the fitting of the panels across the wall and the door is complete. However, remember my cut along here where we can actually see the cut edge. Now there are trims you can purchase to put over things like this. However, I'm going to apply a little bit of furniture wax just over the end of them. I've got a defining wax, so it's kind of a silvery gray color. I'm going to put some tape across the top. I'm going to apply the wax on with a soft sponge. You've only got a small amount left in here, but you do only need a tiny little bit. And it's done. It is as quick and as easy as that. All you need to do now is remove the masking tape. That's my door and walls completed with the acoustic panel boards. If you're looking for more inspiration, follow us on all social media handles. But if you just need to know more about the vast range of products that Walls and Floors stock, head straight over to their website, wallsandfloors.co.uk.